Hi there, welcome. Today we will teach you how to make a fully editable and scalable line chart in Adobe Illustrator. Although there is a line chart graphing tool available in Illustrator, for this tutorial we'll use the Datylon for Illustrator Chart Maker plugin. If you're not a Datylon user yet, just go to www.datylon.com and create a free account in just a few seconds. Don't forget to download Datylon for Illustrator and start your free 14-day trial. You don't even need a credit card. There are many advantages to using the Datylon for Illustrator plugin: full freedom of design, great data management, and more than 120 chart templates to get you started. But with Datylon, you can also easily scale and resize your charts, which is a very powerful and superior feature. In this step-by-step tutorial, we will create two line charts that will visualize the history of the ranking dominance of Djokovic, Federer, and Nadal in men's tennis between 2003 and 2021. This is going to be our final result. Make sure to reproduce the steps and design the line chart with us. It will help you get used to the tool and discover many line chart properties that come in handy when you want to create similar chart visualizations. To begin, open Adobe Illustrator. Let's start by creating an artboard of 1920 by 1200 pixels. Now, click on the Datylon icon to start creating your line chart. Draw a rectangle that more or less reflects the desired size of your chart. And don't worry about the exact size. In Datylon for Illustrator, it's extremely easy to resize your charts and graphs. Now the Datylon window appeared. This is the chart library. Find and select the line chart. As you can see, there are multiple templates available for a line chart. They're quite different from each other, but for this tutorial, we'll select the fourth line chart template. Now that we've selected the chart template, the Datylon editor window appeared. Here, we can bind the data, format the data, or style the chart. Obviously, we need some data to work with. The one you see here is dummy data, but we need to replace it with the actual data file. We have added a link to the dataset below. Now that we have it stored locally on our computer, we can click on Manage Data, and then on Add. In the dropdown, select Import File. Our data is placed into a workbook which consists of two data sheets, year-end ranking and win rates. We'll start with this one. Last but not least, don't forget to click on Select Sheet. And that's it. There is now an error message and the chart is crossed out, but don't worry. That's because the plugin expects values that are bound to the x-axis to be numerical, and currently they're categorical. Just go to the Styling tab. Click on the x-axis, and next to the type, select Categorical. As you can see, the error is gone and everything looks fine now. Thankfully, there are no adjustments needed in the binding, so we can stay in the Styling tab. The first chart is going to be a bump chart reflecting the rankings of the big three on top. To do that, let's go to the y-axis and click on Reverse. If you look at the labels here, they start with 2 and have an interval of 1 label per 2 counts. It makes more sense to start from 1 and have a label for every count. So, let's scroll down and turn the custom ticks amount on. Right below, we can set both ticks interval and starting tick to 1. Oh, and let's turn off minor ticks and grid, as we don't need them in the context of this ranking chart. Better, isn't it? In the Labels section, a bit below, we can change the font size of the labels to 28 pixels, which will look a bit better here. Now both axes labels overlap. To fix this, let's go back to the x-axis and adjust the vertical offset of the labels. 24 pixels should do for us. Since we're here, we can also adjust the size of the labels on the x-axis. That's much better. The next step is to label the lines. back in the styling menu, click on the eye icon next to direct labels. Okay, now we see the labels, but they're not what we hoped for. We can fix this in the binding tab. Let's just add our players' names to each field here. To fix the positioning of the names, we can go back to the Styling tab and, in the Direct Labels, we can change the location to Side. I think that making these labels stay in only one line would be better. Just turn off the paragraph. We will improve the readability of the labels by making them bold and changing the size to 32 pixels. Okay, let's go to Line Properties and increase the stroke to 3. Oh, and let's add data marks by clicking on this eye icon here. As for the coloring of this chart, there are different ways to do it, but as we will want to set specific colors for each tennis player, we will do it at the series level. For each player, we can change the stroke color. We provided the color codes below, but of course, feel free to use any colors you like. Now on to the second chart. First of all, we need to make more room on our artboard to fit another chart. Let's do it by resizing the one we already have. We can copy the current design and paste it in place, which will help us keep the same width of the chart. And of course, move it below so they don't overlap. But we need to change the data sheet. Click Manage Data and select Win Rates. Again, don't forget to click on Select Sheet. If you look below, you'll see that the warning message appeared here at the bottom. It actually means that the starting tick of one of the axes doesn't match the data that is bound to the axis. And we can easily fix it by going to the Y-axis and clicking on the eye icon next to the custom ticks amount. Although the warning message disappeared, the axis still can be improved. We want the highest values on top, not at the bottom. Let's scroll up and uncheck reverse. And as the lower chart is a duplicate of the first one, it also mirrors its x-axis labels, but it's better to turn them off. We will move this line to the top by going to x-axis and clicking on Flip Location. As for the y-axis, we still need a few adjustments. First of all, it represents a win rate, so it's better to add a percentage sign for every axis label. Switching back to y-axis, we can type the percentage sign into the suffix field. Another thing is to adjust the minimum and maximum values, which will also give us a bit of extra room on the top and bottom. Lastly, adjust the width just a bit to align both charts. The last thing to do is to add a title, a subtitle, and some annotations. You might need to resize the charts again to create more space. Using Illustrator's type tool, we can add a title. PT Sans Bold font in size 48 and gray color will work well here. Add a subtitle below, which should be a bit smaller, let's say 32 and regular instead of bold. We can use this subtitle as a legend for our chart. we'll do it by changing the colors of the names of each tennis player. To make it clear what each y-axis is communicating, we'll also use Illustrator's type tool to create additional labels. Just like this. If you look at the top chart, you will see that all the players suffered a significant drop in their ranking, either in 2016 or 2017. We will add annotations to explain this change in performance. Of course, you might not know what the reasons were, so you can either skip or reproduce this step as seen on the screen. We can use the line tool to connect the annotation to the corresponding data mark. It's better to send this one connector line that's intersecting with the chart to the back so that it stays behind the chart line. And that's it! Our line chart design is ready! There are different ways to export this chart. You can export the design as PNG, SVG, or even PDF, just like you would do with any Illustrator project. Then you can use it in different tools like Google Slides or PowerPoint. But did you know that you can also export this chart to our Datylon web app and start collaborating on the template with your team? Just watch how easy it is. Go to Window, Extensions, and Datylon Account. In this window, log into your account. Give the chart a title and description and export it to the Datylon platform. Now you can find this design in the web app. Just go to datylon.com and log into your account again if needed. Your design is now listed in templates. Your teammates can use this design with new data, which then can either be downloaded or embedded elsewhere. Make sure to check out our other videos. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.